So basically, to harness train your cat, you want to desensitize your cat to the actual harness, the sounds that it makes, like the Velcro or the buckle sound, and then also the feel of the harness on your cat's back. You'll want to harness train your cat inside first so that your cat can get comfortable wearing the harness and actually learn how to walk in it, because a lot of cats will just plop and flop with the harness on the first few times. Then once your cat is comfortable and confident in the harness inside walking around, and maybe you might want to play with your cat with the harness on, then you can take your cat outside. Hey friends, it's Jess, and Jericho doesn't want to be filmed right now. He's laying down on the table and giving me support from there. So first you want to buy your cat harness. You can get one from Cat School. That is the blue and gray one here. Has a lot of support and coverage, and there's Velcro straps. There's also this little pocket where you can put a GPS tracker or your cat's ID. There's also the Come With Me Kitty, and this one is kind of more similar to a dog harness, one that has just these little straps and buckles. There's not that much coverage, so it's kind of a con because you don't want your cat to escape from it, but it's also a pro because your cat might be a little more comfortable getting used to it since it isn't as full as the other one. There are other harnesses like Surfer Cat Maeve. This one looks like the Come With Me Kitty harness, but it's a little bit more sturdy. So that's probably the one that I'm going to get next. There's also Catwalk Harness if you want a little bit more coverage, but a little less coverage than the Cat School harness. So first, what you're going to do is get some yummy treats. I use New Zealand Natural Green Tripe Treats because Jericho loves those. I'd highly suggest using something healthy like freeze-dried raw meats or organs. And basically what you're going to do is just put a treat on top of the harness so that your cat can get a little used to the actual harness and get a yummy reward for responding to it positively. Next, you're going to get your cat adjusted to the sound of the harness, whether it's Velcro or a buckle. So get a treat ready in your hand, undo the Velcro or undo the buckle, and then give your treat to your cat immediately. Next, you're going to pet your cat on his back where the harness is going to rest, and that'll help get your cat used to the feel of the harness. And again, he's rewarded with a treat for responding positively. Next, drape the harness over your cat and then give him a treat. Then you can fasten the part that goes around his chest, give him a treat immediately, then fasten the part that goes around his belly and give him a treat immediately. Then stand a few inches away from your cat with a treat in your hand to try to get him to walk. Don't feel like you have to do all of these steps in one day. You want to do gradual and slow training. So stick around 5 minutes a day and you can just focus on one task each day. If you need help keeping track of everything, I sell wonderful printable binders. You can keep track of your habits and your weekly and daily to-do list, and you can also keep track of your cat's progress. Keeping track of your cat's likes and dislikes and how he reacts to the harness is going to help progress your training even further. You can check out my printables in the description below. Thanks so much for your support. Now again, you'll want to practice your harness training inside before you go outside first. Make sure your cat is comfortable walking around in the harness inside, and you might want to even attach the leash to the harness so that you can walk around the apartment. That way your cat will get used to having the harness on and also you guiding him on the leash. And as for healthy cat treats, if the lamb tripe treats don't work for you, check out this video right over meow for more healthy cat treats that are on Chewy and on other online stores. Thanks for watching.